Welcome back, dear students. So this video is for the students of class 9, subject science, chapter number 11, that is work and energy, and this is your lecture number 2. So students, today topics to be discussed in this lecture is what is potential energy, and after that we will derive its derivation. How to calculate potential energy. Clear? So let's start with today's lecture. So what do you understand by the term potential energy? In the last lecture, we discussed kinetic energy. What was the formula of kinetic energy? Half mv square. That was the formula for calculating kinetic energy. Now in this lecture, we shall discuss about potential energy. Okay, let us take an example to understand the concept of potential energy. You might have seen a spring. Okay, a spring. Now let us take that same spring example. You take a spring and hold it from one end. Okay, this one end fixed. Now, when you hold it from both the ends, this is the original position. It is at stationary, it is at rest. Now, the one end is fixed and you are stretching from the other end. Okay, the one end is fixed and you are stretching this from the other end. So, this is a stretchy position. Okay, this distance will increase. Right? Now, after stretching up to this point, you remove it. Okay, you release it. Then what will happen? The spring, it will move back to its original place to acquire its original position. So when it is released, it will move back and regain its original position. Okay, earlier it was original position. When you stretch it, it was increased up to here. The stretching was taking place. Now, when you remove it, it will try to regain its original position. Now, the question arises, when you are stretching it, from where does this spring acquire the energy? Okay, when you are stretching the spring, from where does the spring acquire the energy? From where the energy came? Let us take another example. This is a toy car. Okay. The small babies, they use this toy car. Okay. Now you wind it by using the key. Okay. You wind it. Wind means chabi bharna. You wind it by using a key. Now, did this toy car move after winding? Yes. The toy car moves. Let us suppose it is moving in this direction. Now, from where did this toy car acquire the energy? From where? And does this energy acquire? It depends upon the number of windings. Means how many windings we have given to this toy car. Will that energy depend upon the number of windings? So, how will you find it? So, what we notice from these two examples that the energy gets stored due to the work done on the object. Okay, the work is done on the object. Force is applied and the displacement takes place, means work is done. So, due to this work done on the object, the energy gets stored. Okay, and this energy stored is potential energy. Okay, the energy which is stored, that is potential energy. When you stretch this spring, what is happening? You are transferring the energy to the spring when you are stretching it. Okay, so the energy which is transferred to the spring, that is basically what? That is potential energy. Okay, when you are winding the toy car, you were doing work. Okay, you were doing the work. So what is potential energy basically? Potential energy is the energy possessed ड्यू टू शेप साइज आर पोजिशन. ओके द एनर्जी विच इज पोजेस्ड बाय एन ऑब्जेक्ट ड्यू टू इट्स शेप साइज एंड पोजिशन. सो दैट इज पोटेंशियल एनर्जी. नाउ लेट अस डेराइव दिस पोटेंशियल एनर्जी डेरिवेशन. लेट स्टार्ट. बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द डेरिवेशन लेट अस टेक एन एग्जाम्पल. दिस इज द लेवल दिस ऑफ द ग्राउंड. एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज प्लेस्ड ऑन दिस ग्राउंड. ओके नाउ यू आर रेजिंग दिस ऑब्जेक्ट अप टू सर्टेन हाइट. ओके अप टू सर्टेन हाइट यू आर रेजिंग दिस ऑब्जेक्ट. When it is raised, the object is at here, at height h, right? So, on raising the object through a certain height, an object increases its energy. Why? Because the work is done on it. Force was applied and displacement is taking place. So, work is done on the object against the gravity. Okay, work is done on the object against the gravity. So, what is gravitational potential energy? Gravitational potential energy is defined as the work done in raising an object from the ground to a certain height to that point against gravity. That is gravitational potential energy. Potential energy we write by P dot E dot. Potential energy. Okay? When the object is raised to a certain height, the work is done on this object and this work is done against the gravity. Okay, the work done in raising an object from the ground to that point against the gravity, that is gravitational potential energy. Clear students? It is done against gravity. That's why gravitational. Now let's start with derivation. So let us take the same example. There is an object of mass M which is placed on the ground. Okay, an object of mass M is placed on the ground. Now this object is raised to a certain height. Okay, this object is raised to a certain height. So when it is raised, it reaches to this point. Okay, so final position of the object is here. Okay, so M is the mass of the object and H is height from the ground. This is the ground. So this is a diagram. M is the mass and H is the height. Now, consider the object of mass M which is raised to a certain height from the ground that I told you right now. Now, When this object was raised to this height, means the force was required to do this. Okay. So, the minimum force required to raise the object is equal to the weight of the object. Okay. When we were raising this object to a certain height, some force was required, that is F. Okay. So, what is the minimum force? In order to raise the object to the certain height h, that minimum force will be the weight of this object. And what is weight? Weight is mg, where g is acceleration due to gravity. Okay, now what is work done? Work done is force into distance or displacement. Okay, basically this is displacement. So work done is force into displacement. W for work done, F for force, and displacement in this case is H. So that's why I've written H. Work done is F into H. Now what is force? Minimum force is mg. Okay, so substitute the value of force here. It will be mg into H. So work done is mgh. Okay, and this work done, it is equal to potential energy. Okay, since work done on the object, it is equal to potential energy. So work done is equal to potential energy, that is MGH. So this is the formula for potential energy. Simple, work done is force into displacement. What is force? F, and displacement is H. Okay, so FH, and what is minimum force? That is the weight of this object, Mg, Mg into H, MgH, and this work done, it is equal to potential energy. So potential energy is MgH. Clear? So this is the formula to calculate potential energy, where M is the mass, G is acceleration due to gravity, and H is the height. Now let us take these two cases. In the first case, there is an object which is placed on the ground. Okay? And this object is raised to a certain height, H. And after raising to a certain height, it reaches here. Means the final position of the object is here. And in raising the object from the ground to this position, the path followed is straight. Okay, the object was raised straight. In the second case, what is happening? The object is present here on the ground, like it was present in the first case. It is also raised to a certain height, H, and after raising, it reaches to its final position here. Okay, but what is the difference? Here, the path followed in raising the object is different. Okay, this is the path followed in raising the object. In first case, the path followed was straight. And in the second case, the path followed is zigzag. Some different path is followed. So, in both the cases, the work done by the gravity, it will depend upon the difference in the vertical heights of initial position and final position. This is the initial position and this is the final position in first case. In the second case, this is the initial position and this is the final position. Okay, so the work done by the gravity, it will depend upon the difference in vertical heights of initial position and final position of the object. It will not depend upon the path along which the object was raised or moved. Okay, it will not depend upon the path. Whatever the path followed is in raising the object to a certain height, it will not depend. It will depend upon the difference in initial and final position of the object. Okay, in these two cases, the object is raised from A to B by two different paths. And so what was the potential energy in both the cases? Potential energy, it is equal to MgH. Because the difference between initial and final is H in this case. And in this case also, what is H? Difference in initial and final. Okay. In this case also, the height is same. Initial is this, final is this. The difference between these, the distance, what is this? This is H. So in both the cases, the potential energy is MgH. It will not depend upon the path followed. Suppose this is the path followed and this is the path followed. Now you might be thinking that this height is raised. So this potential energy in this case must be greater. No, it will not depend upon the path. It will just depend upon the difference in initial and final position. Okay, so in both the situations, the work done on the object is same, that is MgH. Clear, students? So this was all about potential energy. Its definition, its derivation, and the third point, that it does not depend upon the path followed. It only depends upon the difference in the vertical heights of initial and final position of the object. Okay? So that's it for today's lecture. What is your homework, students? Your homework is to solve the examples 11.5 and 11.6 given in your NCERT book. Along with these two examples, you shall solve exercise question number 1, 2, 4, 5, 8, 10, 11 and 12. Okay? So these questions, they are just based on work done, kinetic energy and potential energy. Okay? So this is your homework. Do it sincerely. So students, now I am taking the homework solutions of lecture number 1. Page number 152, question number 3. The kinetic energy of the object of mass m moving with velocity of 5 meter per second is 25 joule. Okay, in the question, velocity is given 5 meter per second and the kinetic energy is also given, that is 25 joules. Now what is asking in the question? What will be its kinetic energy when the velocity is doubled? Okay, we are doubling the velocity. So what will be the new kinetic energy? Kinetic energy, the formula is half mv square. Okay, and it is already given in the question that this kinetic energy is 25 joule. Now the question is saying what will be the kinetic energy when the velocity is doubled. So the new kinetic energy, that is kinetic energy dash. So velocity is doubled. So double this velocity. It will be 2v whole square. That will be half m 2v into 2v 4v square. Okay. And you know that this half m v square, that is initial kinetic energy. Okay, this is initial kinetic energy. So it is 4 times of initial kinetic energy. And initial kinetic energy, you know the value that is already provided into the question, that is 25 joules. So 4 times of kinetic energy initial, that is 25. So 4 into 25, that is 100 joule. Okay, so this is the answer of first part when the kinetic energy is doubled. Now second part is, what will be the kinetic energy when the velocity is increased 3 times? Okay, again, kinetic energy initial, that is half mv square. Okay, and the new kinetic energy, that is kinetic energy dash, that will be half m. Now velocity is increased 3 times. It means 3v and it is square, so it is also square. So solve this. Half m 3v square means 9, 3v into 3v 9, 9v whole square. Okay, and this half mv square, this is basically what? Kinetic energy, initial kinetic energy. So 9 times of initial kinetic energy. And the value of initial kinetic energy is already provided in the question, that is 25 joules. So that will be 9 into 25. So that will be equal to 225 joules. Clear? This is very simple. First, find out what is the initial kinetic energy, that is half mv square. Then find out what is the new kinetic energy. Just substitute the values. If the velocity is doubled, 2v. If the velocity is doubled, it will be 3v. Then solve it further and substitute the value of initial kinetic energy from the formula. Okay? And the rest questions, they were just direct questions. So that's why I'm not taking them. I hope you all are clear with all the solutions. So that's it. Thank you.